Okay, we're going to talk about, this is a follow-up to the Gymkhana series. Got a lot of comments. Hope I made some good points. Before we get started, these are the follow-up of the mommies who are still pregnant. It's the big bellies. I thought she was laying down there for a second, but she's not. So, it's hard for me to talk. Can't chew gum and walk, so I can't be focusing this camera and moving around and talking. Let's talk about the Gymkhana series. I got some really good comments. I'm glad that a lot of people see the frustration in what I see, but I really don't want to promote hate. And I don't want to, and there's a few comments on there, and I understand your passion because I have it, and I think it, and I feel it, and I may say it. But the purpose of those tapes is not to get you to hate anybody or to think that those people are necessarily bad people. A lot of things done to horses are done from lack of knowledge. People just don't know, and they don't understand horses, and they don't realize what they're doing. So there's a couple people that want to beat up the one girl who was really beating on her horse. I didn't really like that. She was frustrated. She was showing off. She doesn't realize what she's doing. She's done it her whole life. And again, I'm just guessing. I've never met this girl. She could be an evil witch. But I'm gonna give her the benefit of the doubt. She probably cares about her horse. She probably likes her horse. She probably thinks she takes care of her horse. But she doesn't realize how much damage and what she's doing, because she's caught up in the moment of winning and impressing her friends and not wanting to look bad and ego and all those other pride things that humans have, and it affects her ability to think reasonable. The guy I call John Wayne, I mean, I was calling him John Wayne just so you kind of knew who I was talking about. I go back and I'm kind of funny and I'm being a little sarcastic, but what you didn't see in John Wayne is a few times when I drove by, when I was looking for a place to park and when I was trying to find different things on what to film and what I should film, every time I saw him, he was standing by his horse if he wasn't on and petting him. He was rubbing him. He was next to him. Now, what I saw on John Wayne, if you go back and watch John Wayne, he wasn't necessarily being really aggressive and trying to punish the horse. The girl that was popping her horse in the middle of the arena, that really just popped and yanked, 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 she was punishing. She thought in her mind that she was correcting and that she was showing the horse who was boss. She was in her normalcy bias that's probably what she's been taught. That's what she's been told by old cowboys. That's what she's been told by some of these old barn managers that don't know no difference, and they were told that, so they just repeat it. So when you think about, why is my, I think my lens is fogging up here. That's because I'm blowing out some hot air. Let me get some air going through here. It's pretty windy outside here. I don't know if it's the lens fogging up or the window, but it looks like it's getting foggy to me, but it's not. It's clear. I just noticed that on the little screen. So what I want people to realize is, and again, I don't want people, what the? I don't know if that helped or not. Well, hang on, people. Technical difficulties. Stupid camera. Don't even know how to not fog up. Huh. Much better. Okay, that was, I meant to do that just to show you the difference between foggy and, whatever. Stupid camera. Again, don't be too hard. I mean, I don't mind people being hard and seeing things with a critical eye and saying this is wrong, but I don't necessarily want people to hate somebody because they're doing stupid things. I call people stupid a lot, and I call people dummy a lot. And it's not like I want to punch them in the face or be mean to them, but they're just doing dumb and stupid things. Those people that you saw doing those things were being stupid, because they were uneducated, because they were lack of knowledge, they were lack of understanding. Nobody's ever told them. You know, a lot of reasons I make these tapes is because horsemanship is a dying breed. It's just a lost art. Nobody appreciates it. There's no value in being a good horseman. I mean, somebody will say, well, Rick, you're a good horseman. You got value. Yeah, I got value. I get hate mail. I got people threatening to sue me and fly down here and beat me up and all this hate mail. That, believe me, there's no value in this society in being a good horseman. People don't appreciate it because they don't understand it. They don't see it. Back in the day when horses, everybody owned them and there was value and you looked at people and you respected good horsemen, George Washington was learned. If you go to my website, he was riding horses in his 80s. His horse saved his life. His horse saved his life at 80 when he got washed down a creek. He was able to grab onto the reins and the horse swam while he hung onto the reins and pulled him to safety. You know, I mean, and if you go to my website, you'll know his name. I won't tell you the horse's name, but it's a pretty good name. I think it has a lot to do with American history, but that's just my thought. I don't have any proof of that. But if you go read my horse history page on George Washington, you'll know what his horse's name was that saved a president's life. To me, that ought to be taught in history. Everybody ought to know that. But horses aren't valued. They've lost their usefulness. And now they're kind of trinkets, and they're owned by people who can either afford it or who want to or want a hobby. They're not owned by horsemen that use them and need them and value them and understand and realize what they give and how much they can do for America. So when we see all these people in Gymkhana, you saw these bad things. I don't mind your passion at seeing it's wrong and realizing it's wrong and understanding that you don't ever do that. But I don't want people hating John Wayne. He seemed like a nice guy. I saw him talking to people. He was walking around. He seemed like a genuine nice guy. But he was just, he didn't understand horses. He didn't have a good seat. He didn't understand how much pain he was causing. He didn't have good rein control. He didn't have softness in his hands. He didn't know how to flex. He didn't know all those things. So when I describe it and look at it, it looks bad. Now, had I not known, and you people not known what I was discussing, you hadn't been, people that do not, haven't watched all my videos and maybe haven't been on my website and don't understand what horsemanship is and how much they interfere and hurt a horse and how it's all their fault and it's a mirror of them. People that don't understand that are going to watch that Gymkhana, and I already had some freaking barn witch flying around on her broom trying to tell me that a good horseman would have went over there and told those people what they were doing wrong. People... if see, and that tells me she hasn't watched my video. She doesn't know my site. I tell people, mind your own damn business. Don't be sticking your nose in other people's business. They don't want to hear it. One, they don't want to hear it. Two, if they wanted to hear it, they would learn. They don't care what you say. They don't know you. And most of the advice being given by people like that, they don't know what they're talking about. This lady wants me to run around and tell everybody. If you read the comments, I responded to her in my nice, calm, pink hat, fluffy scarf mentality that I do when I get irritated with stupid comments. But you do not want to go around and try and save horses and try to correct everybody. It just turns out bad. You need to realize every time somebody comes up and tries to help you, or you try to help someone else, if it goes bad, guess who gets blamed? You do. If it goes wrong, guess who gets blamed? If they do it different than what you said when you're not there, they're going to blame you because they're going to say they did what you told them. And I know this from experience because I get this 100 times a month on people calling me saying I did what you did and my horse did this and it didn't work and you're an idiot. Actually, I don't get 100 times. I don't get that a whole bunch. I get people's stupid comments about my horse won't flex and he won't do this and he pulls on the bit and he does. Well, that's because you don't have feel and you don't have time and you don't understand what you're doing. I can get any horse to ride bridleless in about 30 minutes. Now would I take him out on a long trot ride? No. But you give me a round pin and a horse that's been in a bit, I'll put a rope halter on him, I'll lunge him, I'll move him, I'll get him to give to his head, I'll teach him to give to pressure. And if he doesn't, if he isn't totally numb about pressure, he'll learn pretty quick how to give to pressure and how to give that rope halter. And I'll be riding him with a rope halter within 30 minutes to an hour. Now, most people may not be able to do that. But I think most horsemen, people that understand, people that have ridden, people that have confidence, will be able to do that relatively quickly. And again, I get these questions a lot. I want to get my horse bitless. I want to get my horse bridleless. How do I do that? You learn about the horse. You round pin your horse. You spend time in a round pin. You spend time riding him with a rope halter in a round pin where it's safe. So if he does run off, he's only going to go in circles. And you just sit on him and let him run. You teach him that running off isn't going to get him anything. You teach him how to flex. You teach him how to ride in a round pin so he can't run off. So he can't fight you. So he can't win. If you try to teach a horse to ride without a bitless or bridle and you take him out in a pasture or you take him out in an open area and he runs off on you, and then you write me some stupid email about, man, I tried to ride my horse bridleless, Rick, just like you, and he ran off. He was crazy. That horse lost his mind, and then I had to jump off. I'm going to call you an idiot, and then 10 other people are going to write me and say you shouldn't call people idiots. You need to realize when you're training a horse, it's small steps, and you have to set your horse up to succeed. And you have to set up the training scenario so the horse can't fail. When a horse runs off with you because you didn't do the right steps, you let the horse fail. You taught the horse how to win. You taught the horse that it had the ability to run off with you. A horse doesn't learn that he can run off with me in a round pen. He learns that if he doesn't listen to me, I'm going to make him run in a round pen. If I'm on a horse's back and I'm riding bridleless and I say, whoa, and he pulls his head through the bitless bridle, I'm going to say, oh, you're telling me you want to run. Let's run. Let's turn. Let's turn into the fence. Let's back up. Let's do everything to where next time I say, whoa, you're going to be like, yo, man, it's a lot easier to whoa because this guy on my back is crazy. He's a crazy human that's going to make me run like a maniac, and he's going to work the crap out of me if I don't listen to him. Perfect. Now we have an understanding. But Rick, that's not nice. That's not horse. You don't have to be mean to... Oh, get the hell off my channel, you bleeding... You're screwing up horses by thinking in this term that they're your babies and you're going to save them and you have to love them. And I was talking to this horse whisperer, and she said that if you communicate with your Dixie cup, the horse will listen. Come on, people. This is big girl area for training here. Don't be falling into this crap. Don't be a victim. Don't listen to everybody that has advice. Don't be out there following. This lady the other day wrote me this mail. You know, she wants to share her advice with me. She's going to help me. She's going to educate me because she's 57 years old and she's a woman and she knows what women think and she knows that my comments turn off women and they're sexist, and I've got some really great info and I'm the great trainer and I really do horses good, but I need to learn how to talk to women. And you know what? I said, get the hell off my channel and don't email me and lose my email. Look, people, I don't want to hear your comments. People want to share their opinions and tell you what you need to do, etc. I don't ask you to come to my channel. I don't send out emails. I don't put out advertisements. If you notice on my YouTube, they're sending me something every stinking week saying, oh, do revenue sharing on your videos because you get a lot of views. We can put up little Google ads and we can put up all these advertisements and we'll give you money. I don't like watching that crap. If I watch a video and I don't want anybody's watching my videos, I have to put up with stupid ads. Could I make money? Yeah. Would they send me a little money? Yeah. A matter of fact, I did it once on one of my videos on the Mustang because I was going to donate all the money I got to a Mustang foundation. I said, hey, you know what? This will help horses. So I did the revenue sharing, and after some 200, whatever, 20,000 views, I had a whole 5 cents. I said, you got to be kidding me. This is what you call... I stopped that crap. Okay, so that's why you don't see commercials on my videos. If somebody wants to pay me to put a commercial, you see a commercial, then you're going to know that money's going to go to a horse charity. I'm going to donate that to save the Mustangs or to some fund that's going to help horses. But you don't see that because YouTube's playing this, I'll give you 100th of 1 cent for every view, and therefore you need 40 million views to make $5. Well, they can keep their $5. And you people that want to come here and want to hear sweet talking and all that, well, then stay off my channel. I put the information out. If you want it, it's available. This lady, the point I was trying to get to before I went off on all these other tangents, the lady that emailed me about wanting to, that I should learn how to talk to women and nobody's going to listen to me, and unless I learn how to be nicer and understand women better, I'm not going to get anybody watching. I go, I don't care about people. Look, I put the information out. You can come get it. It's free. You know what her response is? I'm never coming to your site again. People, that don't freaking hurt me. I don't care if you cut. You ain't hurting me. I put the information out for horses, and it makes a better life for horses if you want to do it. If you can't take my harshness, you ain't got no business being around a horse, because their harshness is a lot worse than mine. I don't try to be mean. I don't try to isolate. I just call it like it is. I am who I am. And you know what? Whatever. You know, if you don't want to hear that and you want to miss the information, then don't come to my channel. But this lady thinks she's going to punish me, and she's not the first woman that's told me this. They think they punish me by saying, I'm not going to come to your channel, or I'm not going to watch your videos anymore. People, you're hurting yourself. If I was giving out $100 and I told all these women to line up, but when you come up here, I'm going to call you stupid and tell you you don't know crap about a horse, I'd have women lined up for a mile down the street, want their $100, because they'd get something out of it, because it's easy, because that's what they want. But boy, you hurt a woman's feelings when they come out here and you tell them, and man, they don't want nothing. They're going to punish me by not coming and watching my videos. They're punishing their horse. They're punishing themselves. They ain't hurting me. Wise up, people. See the big picture. If you want to learn and you want to understand horses, I put information out there that you're probably not going to get from most people. And if you can, then go to them. I don't care. It doesn't matter. Back to Gymkhana. Please don't hate these people and think they're all bad. I did this and I crack. I just want you to know what runs through my mind and what I see as a horseman when I see bad riders and what I think a bad rider is. A bad rider is someone that doesn't understand, they don't have soft hands, that they don't make themselves an easy load, they don't do the things that I talk about in a lot of my videos about understanding a horse, giving back to a horse when a horse gives you. That little girl that was sitting on her horse, you know, I called her my hero. You'll know who I'm talking about if you watch the videos. She had a good attitude about her horse because she got off by herself and she didn't get these outside pressure. She wasn't getting advice. She wasn't in an arena going in circles, mindless circles for her and her horse, having an instructor yelling, keep your hands down, sit up straight, your heels aren't down, line up your back, curve your back, tighten in your stomach. You know, and people think that's riding. I had some lady email me, and I'll put a link to this lady's video in my comments. And she wanted me to evaluate her riding instructor. And she says, this is my riding instructor. Tell me what you think. Well, I kind of went fast forward if you thought of it. But I wasn't impressed because the girl was riding in an English fashion. She was sitting straight, and she was what I call show riding. She had the horse on the bit. The horse's head was over flexed. There was all kind of problems with that video. And I'll put my comments on what I answered this lady, and I'll put a link. So if you care about that, you can go to the description section and click on that video. I'm also going to put another section on there with another video clip that a girl sent me that she did Gymkhana. And she goes, you can crack on me, but if it helps other people, then go ahead. And I thought that was pretty cool, because none of us are perfect, including me. And I don't think I'm the greatest rider in the world, but I understand horses. And I know, to me, what being a good rider and a good horseman and a good steward of the horse and a good ambassador of the horse is. And that's what horsemanship is. So I'm going to put her video clip in there, and then I'm going to write kind of what I told her. I'll put a copy of what I sent her back about her video. And to me, this girl was communicating with the horse. She didn't have a bit. She was doing the poles. She did a couple things with her horse. It may not look pretty, and somebody on the outside might go, man, that girl's really inexperienced, and she wasn't making her horse go very fast, and that didn't look real great. You know what? I thought it looked great because her and her horse were communicating. She had no bit. She was doing it slow. She did a few things, and I gave her some corrections about her hands, and she was behind the power curve, I thought, on her timing, on giving the horses cues, and she needed to work on it. And I'm going to do a video on rein control, because I talk about that a lot, and I talk about it on Soft Hands Make Soft Horses video, but I don't know if it's resonating like it should. So I'm going to tie a rope to a stinking fence and show you how to do an exercise on rein control. So anyway, don't be too hard on these people on Gymkhana. Read the description. I'm going to have two video clips that you can watch. And I'll have a description on kind of what I saw, what my view is on those video clips. And again, this is about learning, people. This is about seeing things from a different point of view, breaking the normalcy bias that's in the horse world, breaking that show the horse who's boss, manhandling, breaking the myth about those horse whispers and these swirls and the color of hoofs and breeding and all these other things that people want to get you to think that's what makes a good horse. None of that matters. What matters is you, your understanding, your compassion, your ability to understand and work with the horse, give back to the horse, and be a good steward and ambassador of the horse. That's what horsemanship is. Hope that helps. I'm sure this video is pretty exciting, looking at these horses being wild, crazy horses. And there's that blanket that I've seen on the same horse every week for the last 2 months that I won't go on. I'll try to end this positive. Hope that helps on improving your horsemanship and understanding Gymkhana. Talk to y'all later. Buddy, Mr. T, you're a good boy.